Hi guys, this is gsno.com and I'm here with the Xiaomi Redmi K20, or as some people know it, the Xiaomi Mi 9T in some parts of the world, especially Europe. We have here the 6GB of RAM, 64GB storage version, and the price tag should be around $309. That's what Amazon is telling us. So this phone is available in red, black or blue. Let's see which version we have here. It's been a phone that's been a long time coming. We'll be looking forward to testing it, because Redmi has become a bit of a separate entity from Xiaomi. They're almost their own self-contained company. And you can see here, Redmi designed by Xiaomi. Let's see what we got here. So we have this metal key used to access the slots. And then we have the manuals, very small, pretty slim. And of course, a case, or rather a back protection with some minor protection for the sides. Okay, and the unboxing goes on. Let's put this aside, and here we are with the star of the show. The star of the show is obviously the phone. It's this one here, and it's got the user guide, yet another one, and this paper thingy. Okay, so Redmi K20 is here, and I guess I'm going to have to peel off the plastic layers. So let's start with the one at the front. And by the way, it has some specs listed on it. You can see there's a AMOLED screen here, 6.39 inches. And also 48 megapixel camera at the back inside a triple setup, which you can see right now. This is the triple setup and this is the flash. Here you can see the SIM card slots, and just let me peel off this other plastic layer. Okay, with this satisfying feeling done, let's analyze the device. So as I said before, we are getting here a niftily colored version. I'm pretty happy we didn't get the black one. We have the blue one, and it reminds me of the Honor View 20 or the Honor 20 Pro from Huawei, which had the similar pattern, even though this one is darker in the center and lighter on the sides. Looks a bit like a, well, I would say a pearl, if there's such a thing as a blue pearl. Definitely glass, and glass at the front, and a metal frame in between, aluminum. Okay, and also I see that the power button is a different color, red. Got that figured out. And then we go further into the unboxing and discover the charger, which may require an adapter in some parts of the world, especially European countries. No headphones here. And then we find the cable. It's of the USB Type-C to USB-A variety. Okay, we're done. We're done with the unboxing. Let's fire up the phone and see what it's all about. So if you look closely, you'll see there's no cutout here, there's no notch. That's because the selfie camera is right here. It has a motorized mechanism, it pops up, and you still have the audio jack. No trace of a fingerprint scanner on the backside, because it's embedded into the screen. The Xiaomi Redmi K20, or the Mi 90, as I would have it, has a pretty narrow bezel screen, as you can see here, and I guess it's time to start the setup. Okay, choosing the region properly, let's see. Okay, so I guess it's time to talk about the specs. We're getting an 8.8 millimeter thickness phone here. That's the waistline, and it weighs a hefty 191 grams. The screen you're seeing here is a 6.39 inch Super AMOLED with a resolution of 2340 over 1080 pixels. It's got HDR support, so that's a plus. And inside we find the octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 730 CPU, accompanied by 6GB of RAM. Okay, and also 64 or 128GB of storage, and no microSD card slot. That's important to remember. There is a 4000 mAh battery inside that does 18W fast charging. And time to talk about the cameras. So what we're having here is a triple setup. It's a combo of 48 megapixels, it's a Sony sensor, combined with an 8 megapixel telephoto lens with 2x optical zoom and a 13 megapixel ultra wide camera. They shoot 4K at 30 frames per second, and there's a dual LED flash below the camera setup. So MIUI 10 still being set up on top of Android Pie, and once we'll get to use the device, you'll see that this pop-up selfie camera is quite potent. It's got a 20 megapixel resolution, and also it has drop detection. So when the phone detects you're dropping it, it will retract the motorized camera. This is a dual SIM phone that has a singular speaker at the bottom, USB Type-C port, and here you can find the slots neatly tucked on a SIM tray. Other than that, Bluetooth 5.0 in the mix, audio jack, embedded fingerprint scanner, and I actually did a bit of research about the phone, and here we go. At last, I did a bit of research and actually found out that the Sony 48 megapixel camera at the back is not the IMX586 but rather the IMX582. At least that's what the Xiaomi India's website is showing us. And now the moment of truth, the moment you will be waiting for, we go to the camera UI and pop up the selfie camera. As the Americans say in the movies, pop goes the weasel. Here we go. Wow, that's a pretty badass sound. And it also lights up. Check this out. So, how cool is that? The edges of the camera light up. Now let's see from the back. I've seen motorized pop-up cameras before, but this one is the most badass ever. So, let's try it again. Come on. Brilliant. Truly brilliant. Look forward to testing it. Okay, and I can see here that we have a 48 megapixel option, so you can take the full resolution shots. We have a portrait option, we even have a night option, panorama, pro, and so forth. So, Xiaomi cameras have been evolving a lot. Ever since the Mi Mix 3, there has been a clear upgrade in camera quality, and I only expect the best from the Xiaomi Mi 90 or the Redmi K20, as some people may know it. Video capture, slow motion part of the package, short video, everything checks out. And as usual, MIUI is pretty minimalistic and straightforward with this shelf area or the app vault that tells you important stuff. And there's no app drawer as far as I can see. So that's that. This has been the unboxing and the first impression is about the Xiaomi Mi 90 or the Redmi K20. So far so good, and I fell in love with the lighting of the selfie pop-up camera. We'll be back with a full review very soon. In the meantime, this is a phone that's around $300 and it's well worth the price. This is jason.com. This is the unboxing of the Redmi K20. Bye bye.